this AI can transform any of your pictures into accurate representation with a Disney animated movie character style. You can even use it on yourself right now with a simple click using Toonify. It's the first link in the description. But before testing it out, let's quickly see how it works. This is What's AI, and I share artificial intelligence news every week. If you are new to the channel and want to stay up to date, please consider subscribing to not miss any further news. Using a publicly available pre-trained model called StyleGAN2, they were able to create Toonify, a website transforming any picture taken from profile into a Disney, Pixar, or DreamWorks animated movie character. StyleGAN2 is a GAN architecture model made by the NVIDIA research team. It currently has state-of-the-art results in generative image modeling. In short, they used the original StyleGAN architecture and improved it to improve the style-related results. This network is a generative adversarial network, merged with Style Transfer. Style Transfer is a technique used to change the style of a whole image based on the different styles it was trained on, as you can see here. The generative adversarial network, what we call GAN, is then the base architecture of the network. It's basically composed of two main parts. At first, there's what we call a generator network, which learns high-level attributes of the human faces it is trained on, such as pose and identity of the person, to control the image synthesis process. This is where it learns the style of the images fed, such as a human style or a Disney cartoon style. Then, to train this generator, we need the second part of the GAN architecture, which is a discriminator. In short, both generated and real images are fed to the discriminator during training, which tries to discriminate the real images from the generated ones. Based on this comparison's feedback, the generator network can iteratively improve the quality of the fake images and fool the discriminator. As I said, Toonify used a pre-trained model, which is a model that has already been trained on many images, yielding good results. Then, they fine-tuned it by training their generator again with 300 more animated movie character pictures related to Disney, Pixar, and DreamWorks world. Then, merging specific parts of two different GAN networks, such as one trained on human faces and another one trained on animated movie characters, they were able to create a hybrid which has the structure of a cartoon face, but photorealistic rendering. This gives a high-quality cartoon style look to any person, and not any cartoon style, but the one it has been trained on, which in this case are Disney, Pixar, and DreamWorks movie characters. You could do these same steps on any other cartoon styles if you have enough images of this specific style. The one impressive thing here is what they've done by merging the two networks. In short, they understood that the first few layers were responsible for the pose of the head and shape of the face, which is controlled by the human faces GAN-trained network. Then, they saw that the latter layers were more about controlling things like lighting and texture, which is what we are looking for with the cartoon images, allowing them to generate images from an entirely novel domain and do this with a high degree of control, meaning that they could conserve the property of the human face it was fed with and generate a cartoon version of it, with a specific style such as Disney characters, rather than generating images with random properties that are not really following the shapes and the soul of the image fed, like most approaches. They call this the layer swapping technique in their paper, which I linked in the description, as well as the Toonify website, where you can try to cartoonize yourself or any picture you want. The Toonify website is the first link in the description, if you would like to try it out on yourself or any picture you want. But here's a quick note from the authors before testing it yourself. To produce great results, the original image must be of fairly high quality, such as around 512x512 pixels for the face. Then, side faces and faces of under 128x128 pixels are unlikely to be found by the network. Have fun and please share your results in the comment section with a link to your images or tag me on Twitter using @whatsai. I would love to see them. Please leave a like if you went this far in the video. And since there are over 90% of you guys watching that are not subscribed yet, consider subscribing to the channel to not miss any further news clearly explained. If you would like to start or improve with machine learning, I've linked all the best online courses in a repository in the description. Thank you for watching.